Okay. Alright, I'm just gonna say that I don't know what I'm doing here. I just saw this and I'm like, hey, this might be a visual novel. Whatever, my name's not Taylor. You can go be a bum. I am Dominic. That's my real name. And I'll just... No, this isn't a video game. This is
technically a video game, but still, it's not a video game.
Chapter 1, this must be heaven. Yay. See, I don't know why I hit this. It's just gonna be like, I don't know. It's a visual novel, kind of, and I've always wanted to do this, so. Stay down, it's coming this way. Nick, give me your hand. Oh no! And you, of course not, but you will in time. What? I don't know! What is going on? The plane shudders. The plane shudders, jolting you awake. You blink away the strange dream as your eyes adjust to the bright sunlight outside. Whee! This plane looks nice. I'm gonna be in a plane like this. I look very much not like me. This is the only one that is suitable, I guess. I mean, it's not a race thing, alright? That just popped into my head, so don't think that. Best friend Diego gives you a goofy smirk from the seat behind you. What if she did? Still not dreaming, right? Doesn't feel real, does it? Yeah, we're finally on our way. The chatter of the 10 contest winners from your school fills the plane. The 10 people!
One magical week in paradise, here we come!
All expenses paid. What? With 3-2, I'm so deep in student depth, I couldn't even afford instant ramen right now. Hello. Okay, Nick, bad dream? I just had just a really weird one. I dream about him. You can recognize the guy walking down the aisle towards you. What's up, homie? I don't know. What I dream about Sean. I'm gonna call him Sean. I know it's Sean, but still, every time I see it, I'm gonna say Sean. So, I'm gonna say Sean. You had a dream about Sean Gale? Well, what are you waiting for? Go talk to him. Pushes you out into the eye, where you pass by. You bump into each other. Well, hello there. Friend Nick here wants to say something. Diego, shut up. This doesn't kind of make sense anymore. Like, I'm not gay. You're still on my bucket list. Oh, yeah. What if Miss Hachette's think we're landed to? So, like we said, choices affect your relationship with everyone you meet. I can't actually take your change because I don't feel about you. For now. Oh, man! Over time, their behavior towards you will change. Build friendships, make enemies, even find a romance. Well, okay. I'm not gonna do that. John shoots you a smile and says bye. Oh man, got that whole thing on video. You gotta see your face. What? How weird, really? 5:15? We should have landed an hour ago. It didn't feel like you were soaring that low. However, so I'll go ask the pilot if something's up. I'm being chipped if you can hear that, by the way. Make way forward. They pass by the other students talking loudly over each other. Oh god! I gotta get this guy the best voice. He hates life. Okay, I don't even know what happened there.
Excuse me, will you all please cease your babbling? The tour guide is trying to speak.
Thank you, Alistair. As your tour guide for the week, I just want to say that we should all try to, you know, be friends. It is an island after all, so you're kind of stuck to each other, hee. Is it too late to jump out of the plane?
Emo! This is an emo girl. But if I was going to an island, I wouldn't complain. I just need a good hair dryer.
Because every time I get my hair wet, it will take forever to dry my hair. Even with the hair dryer, I'm like sitting there for an hour. The pilot has his combat boots kicked up on the dashboard. Why are you wearing combat boots? Weirdo. You're on a plane. What the hell was that? I don't know what that was. If you didn't hear it, okay, you probably didn't. Excuse me, it's Jake, right? Weren't we supposed to have landed by now? Wait, are you asleep? Huh? Stay out, it's coming this way. Listen, Boy Scout, don't you know it's rude to wake someone who's taking a nap? You're a freaking pilot, bruh! Boy Scout. What can I say? I give nicknames to people who annoy me. In that case, I'm calling you. Aragorn. Aragorn? I don't know what you're talking about. Lord of the Rings? Never heard of it. Oh, come on! You're a bad liar. Fine, call me Aragorn. I like it. The man was a badass. Anyway, relax. We ain't landed until the hell the time ain't right. And that ain't right either. You sure you know what you're doing? You about half the things that's tried, you'd bet on me to get you through anything. Oh no! I'm thrown into the wall of the cockpit. Ah! Oh yo! Ah! We're going in the clouds! I don't like this. Everything's red. Oh, just great. The storm front's coming in quick. Losing grabs the yoke. Yoke, get your ass in the seat here. Tell everybody to buckle up. But now, Boy Scout. Dark clouds closing around the plane. Gusts rocking it side to side. Everyone starts shouting. Oh, really regretting that airport for Chipotle. What? Out of all the things, not the Chipotle. Don't puke, bro. If you puke, I'm gonna puke.
Where the hell did this storm come from? It was a clear day.
Happens to say this is totally normal.
That was normal.
Yep. Lightning balls everywhere. And orange things. Okay, one of them hit the plane! Oh, balls of orange electricity coalesced. How do you say that? Coalesced out of the dark sky and exploded in its crackle of sparks. Looks like ball lightning. But I've never seen anything quite like this.
This all along, you can't join here surrounded by these morons.
Hey, we won the same competition you did, loser. Everyone just breathe, we're gonna get through this. Breathe, don't forget to breathe.
Oh god, oh god.
Blistering crack of thunder deafens you as lightning strikes the plane. Sparks fly in the cockpit. Nope, engine just lost power. Bring her down manually, everyone hang on. Your shouting grows louder as your classmates start to panic. All except one. Girl with a tight ponytail and a long scar across her eyes sits alone in the back row. But it's silent and unfazed.
Nick, safety first. Please find a seat.
I don't need a seat. Can I have space around you? Who should I seat? Quinn. I'll meet you people. Tumble into the seat next beside Quinn as the plane was about. It's not because she's a girl. Don't think that. Nick, Quinn's face is drawn tight. He's in the look. It's like you're like, so. Just breathe, it'll pass. This can't happen, not yet, it's too soon. That's our sight, your chest rising and falls shallow. She's having trouble breathing. So he's looking at her chest? I'm terrible. I'm not doing that. Hey, why couldn't someone do it? Well, I have no idea. Because they're cantaloupe. I don't know. Couldn't switch your voice for until. Because cantaloupe. Ha, that's funny. Good, can't hold it, she makes that most infectious laughter you ever heard. Oh, you're positively mad. This isn't the time for jokes. Gotta light up the spirits, douchebag. That's perfect time for jokes.
She offers you her hand. You take it. She smiles sweetly, and it somehow makes all the shouting and alarms fade into the background. I'm Quinn. Nick.
Yeah, romance! Awesome! A little farther, I think we're almost out.
Lightning reaches the fever pitch. The plane bursts out of the storm clouds into clear sky.
Whee!
Clear sky is awesome.
Woohoo! We're alive!
Nick, look, there it is.
Get a good look now. I'm coming in fast.
Welcome to La Huerta. Huerta? I don't know how to say that.
La Huerta! Endless summer.
Wait. The plane sinks towards a gorgeous, sprawling island. At its center, a volcano rises above the rainforest, breathing a white color smoke.
Oh no, not a volcano!
It's gonna erupt while we're here, isn't it? It is.
La Huerta Tower, this is tail number XCDMK, requesting an emergency priority to land.
Radio.
It's three dots. It's like dot, dot, dot. Carlos, pick up, you lazy bastard. It's Jake. Ignore me, won't make it for the $100 you owe me. Like it or not, we're coming in.
$100. Plane lands on a dirt airstrip at the edge of the island. Pulling into it. Sorry, I had to throw away the bag.
Falling into the ladder.
I don't know what that was.
We step down the stairs in the warm, tropical sunshine. Rough landing, Aragorn. Hope you don't work for tips. Kidding, I'm a damn here for even getting you on the ground.
Carlos, hey, tune up. Carlos! Jake rushes off the rest of the group, pulls their luggage from the plane's cargo bay. This is supposed to be one of the most beautiful places on Earth, the beaches, the waterfalls.
It's also home to a plethora of rare flora and fauna.
If you don't know what flora is, it's flowers. If you don't know what fauna is, it's animals. There.
10 spots on the trip, and they had to give one to this dork.
You reach for your suitcase handle, just as Sean does. Scene, whatever. Oh, sorry.
I want to carry my bag. Right ahead.
Oh my god, could you be any more desperate?
Okay. Let's see. Why do you always have around the spotlight like moths?
Spotlight? What?
As if you don't know who Shane is. John is, whatever. Chief Smith's star quarterback, the Heisman frontrunner. Guys, cool, chill out.
Don't see, there's gonna be any fame hounds hanging around. Got it?
Michelle now dislikes you. Okay.
Just don't think of a comeback. Don't worry, I'll wait.
You!
Michelle, can you chill? And I don't mean Netflix and chill. I mean actual.
Hello! That's hilarious.
An actual chill, please.
I need Michelle, a relationship I gotta change.
Michelle, you back away. Your foot clings on something.
Now, what's this?
Is that a tranquilizer dart?
The island is full of clues that unlock the mysteries of La Huerta. They're hidden within choices and new areas to explore.
They're within hidden choices. I can't read, alright? They're hidden within choices
and new areas to explore.
Collect all the clues in an act to unlock an exclusive bonus scene. Play the chapters to find them all.
Clue found.
The vial's nearly empty. Must have hit its target.
Yeah, this is a pretty big deal. So whatever animal they took down must have been huge.
I mean, if they took it down.
Someone watching it from nearby, listening to their conversation.
What's up, Scar Lady?
Hey, Diego, who's that?
Dunno. Got the eyes for the furious honey, huh?
Hottie, huh? Okay.
There's something off about her.
Who gave you that idea?
She's too quiet.
Quiet? So what? I'm quiet? Well, when I'm not around you.
Guess you're right. I don't know why I'm being suspicious.
Huh. Well, blah, blah, blah. What?
So that 10 students from our college had one trip, right? Obviously you're not counting the pilot or the guide, but... Count us off. She makes 11. Look at the girl's direction once more, and this time she's staring directly back at you. Your eyes lock. What's up, mysterious lady? You try to look away, but for some reason you can't. She's pulling you in with her gaze. That's weird. Hey, Lila, where the hell are your people? Jake storms back, and at last the silent girl looks away. The strange hold over you disappears. You shake it off. There's nobody here. You all look around. You and your group are still the only people on the airship. Airstrip. We should be here in a shuttle to take us to the main resort, but I'm sure it's just a slight delay. No need to fret. They'll be here any minute. Yeah, you know, not like they're all dead. They aren't dead. Hell with that. I'm going up that control tower to get some answers. What do you think is going on there? No idea. Call it a gut feeling, but whatever it is, it ain't good. So, Boy Scout, you coming or not?
I can go with you.
I wasn't talking to you, Maybelline. Wow.